fire.
And burn, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The face of living sleep, when hearts like our dream. I built for you like a child.
I'm
smoking in a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. Well, I know I had it coming. I know I can't be free. But those people keep moving, and that's what torture means. pleasure to be with you tonight, and thanks for coming to our show. We love to see, I don't dance or tell jokes or wear my pants too tight, but I know a lot of songs. Some of these songs we've been singing for 25 years or more, but if you enjoy hearing them, they're just like brand new to me. I'll start off with one that from the 70s. It wasn't too well known, but I like to sing it because it's a love song about a woman that was just kind of passing through, you know? You know, like some of them do. Oh, it's Christmas, like cotton candy clouds that sail the day, slow and free, and she possesses a mind that can't resign itself to stay along with me. Though I've tried and tried to keep her tight and satisfied until she really needs me. But when that certain look comes on her face, I can't replace it, and she leaves me. Wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that bold blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Yes, she will. Yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Oh, she needs me about as much as I need someone else, which I don't. And if need be, I swear someday I'll up and leave myself. But even if she loved another man, I'd understand it more than I do. Still I know the only reason that she ever has for leaving is she wants to, which is a pretty good reason, I guess. She's a butterfly in mid-July and just can't wait to try her brand new. She needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Yes, she will. Oh, yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind. To my daughter Cindy. Cindy. Well, around this fast, I've seen you all a lot. Yeah. I want to show you a song here. Show you a song. Yes. Ready? Well, wish I. Learn. think a heart too. If I had known you longer, you might be a little stronger. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. As he walked into the pool room, you could tell that he didn't fit. In his handmade boots and custom suit, pearl handle shooting stick. Well, tonight there'd be a showdown. Then everyone would know who shoots the meanest game around, the Baron or Billy Joe. Billy Joe looked edgy, about to lose his cool. But the Baron's hands were steady as the two began to duel. Yeah, he was like a general on a battlefield of slate. And he would say to Billy Joe, each time he sunk the eight, he'd say, well, I wish I had known you when you were a little younger. Round me you might have learned a thing or two. If I had known you longer, you might be a little stronger. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. Now Billy Joe was busted, but he hadn't felt the sting. And from the far end of the table, he tossed his mother's wedding ring. And he said, you wanted my money, but it ain't gonna do the trick. I'll bet this ring on one more game against your fancy stick. The Baron's eyes got foggy as the ring rolled on the belt. Then he almost doubled over, like he was hit below the belt. 20 years ago, it was the ring his wife wore, and he didn't know before he left that a son would soon be born. It sounded just like thunder when the Baron shot the ring, but it grew quickly quiet as he lined up the eight. Then a warm hand touched his shoulder, and it chilled him to the bone when he turned and saw the one who had loved him for so long. The game was never finished, the eight ball never fell. The Baron calmly picked it up, put it on the shelf. Then he placed the ring in the hands that held his long ago, and he tossed that fancy shooting stick to his son, Billy Joe. And he said, well, I wish I had known you when you were a little younger. Around me you might have learned a thing or two. If I had known you longer, you might be a little stronger. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. Maybe you'd shoot straighter than you do. He was a mountain of a man, and I want you to know he could preach hot hell or freezing snow. He carried a Bible and a canvas sack, and everybody called him the Reverend Mr. Black. He was poor as a beggar, but he rode like a king. Late in the evening, I could hear him sing. I got a wolf.
I got a wolf.
That lonesome valley.
Lonesome valley.
I got a wolf.
I got a wolf.
By myself. Ain't
nobody
here.
Nobody
here. And walking for me.
Walking for me.
I got a wolf.
I got a wolf.
By myself.
By myself.
Well, if ever I thought that this man in black was a coward or had any yellow up his back, I gave that notion up the very day a lumberjack came in and it wasn't afraid.
Now, he kicked open the meeting house door and he cussed everybody up and down the floor. And when things got quiet all over the place, he walked up and cussed in the preacher's face. He hit that preacher like a kick of a mule, and my way of thinking it took a pure fool to turn the other cheek to that lumberjack. That's what he did, the Reverend Mr. Black. He stood like a rock, a man among men, and he let that lumberjack in him again. But then with a voice as kind as could be, he cut him down like a big old tree when he said, "You got a woman, that lonesome valley. You got a woman, get by yourself. There ain't nobody here can walk it for you. You got a woman, get by yourself." Well, it's been many years since we had the part, and I guess I've learned all his ways by heart. I can still hear his sermon ring down in the valley where he used to sing. getting hard, and the word is there. Thank you. I'd like to do a song that we did on the soundtrack. I did a movie, a CBS movie of the week, called The Pride of Jesse Hallam, where I played an illiterate old man. I was watching the Emmy Awards that night, and I knew that I wasn't going to get an Emmy for Best Actor of the Year, because nobody could call me and say, get ready to come to Hollywood or anything like that. I was out picking my guitar anyway, so I was just as happy. But anyway, I want you to know I was nominated for an Emmy for Best Actor of the Year movie in the Pride of Jesse Hallam. This band was nominated for an Emmy for the Best Soundtrack of the Year in the movie of the week, The Pride of Jesse Hallam. And they lost too. Well, I'd like to do a song from that film, but I want to tell you that this next year, June and I are going to do a movie. And we're going to do another CBS movie of the week. This time, she's going to be in this movie with me. And it's a very good story. And it's one that we've really looked forward to doing. I don't know what the title is going to be right now, but the book is called Murder in Coweta County. It's a true story that happened in 1948. And it's a part that I'm really looking forward to doing. I think it's really going to be a fine movie. I hope you'll be watching for it. That's going to be a long time. We've got a lot to do before then. We've got a Christmas special on next week on the 10th of December. And four more shows here, two tomorrow and two Sunday. And then... days I'm going to be dying. I'm just an old chunk of gold, but I'm going to be a diamond someday. I'm going to grow and glow till I'm so blue, pure, perfect. I'm going to put a smile on everybody's face. Oh, but I'm lest I should become vain along the way. I'm just an old chunk of coal now, Lord, but I'm gonna be a diamond someday. Until I get rid of every single flaw. Oh, I want to be the world's best friend. I'm going around shaking everybody's hand. I'm just an old chunk of coal now, Lord, but I'm going to be a diamond someday. I'm just an old chunk of coal. He's a record. He produced Roseanne Cash, so I think he knows what he's doing. I'm proud of her. and Nick Lowcock. There's some I won't mention. There were some of them that just really weren't worth killing. Hey! You did! Anyway, Cowboys, it's called Bull Rider.
Thank you.
quit. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught him yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses roar and fire.
Old Chris Thompson wrote this in one of his better moments.
Thank you. Little bit better acquainted, okay? being able to sing with my sisters is the harmony that we sung together. And I love this old part of family song, and my good friend Emily Harris has this one in one of her newer albums, and she has Linda Ronstadt singing it with her. And since I don't have Jimmy Lou and Linda here tonight, I'd like to ask Bob and Marty to be Jimmy Lou and Linda.
Since this is such a wonderful kind of high-class audience, I really did want
want to do something with a little classical feel to it tonight, so I picked one of my very special tunes from the mountains called There's a Rabbit in the Log, and I ain't got my...
Thank you.
the magazines. Nobody else. Pictures, they get every place. And try to get pictures of you. It's okay. I always wear two pairs of those breeches. Send me one pair. We get a lot of requests for this song, and we'll sing it for you, and then we will take a little intermission.
Do it anyway.
We got married in a fever.
called Rockabilly Boogie.
You're welcome, Earl Poole.
I'd like to do an old Jimmy Rogers song for you if I could. He didn't ask for it, but...
Oh, Jimmy, spit on him in the third row.
He did this, he did this about 1927. He didn't do it quite like that.
Thank you.
graduated from high school and I hitchhiked to a Pontiac, Michigan. Got a job working in the car factory. They were talking about it back even then. Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 when in Detroit working on the assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry. Always wanted me one of them long and black. Well, one day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now, getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured to have it all by the time I retire. Got me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece of time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come to your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. Well, the very next day when I checked in with my big lunchbox and helped my friends, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I never considered myself a thief, but GM would miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. Well, the first day I got me a fuel pump, the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, and I got me a transmission and all chrome. Little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, big stuff snuck out in my buddy's mobile home. Well, now, up to now, my plan went all right till we tried to put it all together one night, and that's when I noticed that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73. When we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit with a little bit of help from an ADAP kit. Had that engine running just like a song. The headlights was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right. But when we pulled out the switch, all three of them come on. The back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together and when we got through, that's when I noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out and I could see in her eyes that she had a doubt, but I said, come here, honey, I want to show you my car and take you to watch the fin. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. What's that front end there? What's that? What's that? See, I got one door on this side, honey. You can ride up here with me. Come around, let me see. Look out. Ooh, 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 look out. I got two doors on this side. Oh, baby. Thank you. Thank you very much.
all right. You know, about 11 years ago, 10 or 11 years ago, I was asleep one afternoon, and June said, came and woke me up and said, "Well, they've been coming by land and sea. We live on a lake and tourists." I said, "Well, that's all right." She says, "No, some fool has landed in the yard in a helicopter." So I went out, and it was Chris Christopherson, and he was getting out of his Army Reserve helicopter with beer in one hand and a tape in another. He said, "See, he's been working as a janitor at Columbia Records up until then." He said, I'm going to get a song to you one way or another. And I said, "Well, you just did. You got it to me. Let's listen to it." So we listened to it, and we recorded it. Well, I woke up Sunday morning with the weight of all my hands. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found the cleanest, dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair, and stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before by cigarettes and songs that I'd been picking. But I lit my first and watched a small boy cussing at a can that he'd been kicking. I crossed the empty street, caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. It took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, oh, I'm wishing more that I was gone. Cause there's something in a Sunday that'll make your body feel alone. Song was too painful for him to sing. And I said, "Well, let me hear it." So he sang the song. I said, "Well, I like that song. I'm not feeling any pain. I'd like to record that song, Chris. Anyway, we did. You see, Rita had just split on him, and he wrote this song about that. It's called, this is for all you lovers, all you that want a lover, don't have a lover, need a lover. Unlove. It's called The Last Time. Darling, the seasons are changing. See now the leaves, how they die. Love needs no reason for ending. Come kiss your baby goodbye. Darling, the last time you lied, was it really the last time? Have all the tears that you've cried simply dried up and gone? All in the world you can hurt anymore is my feeling. Whatever love ever was never lasted. The best of our life was a beautiful dream that conscience was destined to crumble like castles of sand. All there is left of our love is a little girl's laughter. Let her keep making believing as long as she can. Now and again I still hear some old song I don't want. Is it the same over there where you found your new friend? Sometimes at night I still wake up and feel something missing. Maybe I'll never be leaving forever again. Darling, the seasons are changing. See now the leaves, how they die. Love needs no reason for ending. Come kiss your baby goodbye.
Old, and I looked at him and my blood ran cold and I said, my name is Miss Sue, how do you do? Now you're gonna die. Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes, and he went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Then I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the walls and down the street, kicking and gouging in the mud and the blood and the beer. Well, I'll tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He came like a mule, and he bit like a crocodile. I heard him laughing, and I heard him cuss. He reached for his gun, but pulled my purse, and he stood there looking at me, and I saw him smile. And he said, son, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name, and I said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough or die. It's that name that helped to make you strong. He said, now you just fought one heck of a fight, and I know you hate me, and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your gut and the spit in your eye, because I'm the first name you sue. What could I do? I got all choked up and I threw down a gun. I called him a paw and he called me a son. Come away with a different point of view. Think about it. Now and then, every time I tried, every time I went, if I ever have a boy. Well, I had a boy that looks a whole lot like his mama, but he's crazy about it, isn't he? We have requested to, we'd like to do a couple of songs the way we recorded them back in the mid-50s when we started. We'd like to get W. S. Holland to come down on the snare drum.
What do you got on?
Board.
said, I got livestock, I got livestock. I got cows, I got the pigs, I got sheep, I got mules, I got all livestock, I got all livestock, I got all livestock. He said, you ain't got no pig iron on there, do you? What's pig iron? He said, slop. He said, oh, no, I got none of that. The man said, get that train out of here. You're holding up the traffic. Get it on out. So he started picking up a little bit of speed, a little bit of steam. Pulled on out of the toll gate, heading on. Got on to the toll gate. He turned and looked back at the man. He said, well, you got big iron, I got big iron, I got all the big iron, I got all the big iron, I got all the big iron. Down to Rock Island, the mighty good road. Rock Island is a road to ride. Rock Island, the mighty good road. If you ride, you got your life like it might get you to that station on the Rock Island. Cloudy in the west, and it looked like rain around the curve of a passenger train. Northbound, west, southbound, right. All right, a little buddy, when you put back down to Rock Island, the mighty good road. Rock Island is a road to ride. Rock Island is a mighty good road. Well, if you ride, you get right like you might get sticking this place to Rock Island. Well, he got on up to southern Illinois where the land is rich and black and flat. His train runs good on the ground like that. I don't know if he can get any faster or not. ABCWXYZCAT, we're coming by the whole city. Down Rock Island, mighty good road. Rock Island, a road to ride. Rock Island, mighty good road. Well, if you ride, you gotta ride like mighty good stick of that slate snow. Rock Island.
Well, I talked to weeping a little old, how to cry, and I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears I cried for that woman, gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her draw, Southern draw. Then I heard my dream run back down the street, Fortin and Davenport, and I follow you, big river, when you call.
Oh, that lady,
all you rounders if you want to hear the story about a brave engineer. Casey Jones was the roller's name, and on a six-seater wheeler boys he rode to fame. Well, the caller called Casey about a half past four. He kissed his wife at the station door, climbed in the cabin with his orders in his hand, said this is the trip to the promised land. Casey Jones mounted to the cabin. Casey Jones, orders in his hand. Casey Jones leaning out the window, taking a trip to the promised land. Rain been a-pumping and the water was high. Everybody knew by the engine was born. The man at the throttle was Casey Jones. Casey Jones mounted to the cabin. Casey Jones, orders in his hand. Casey Jones leaning out the window, taking a trip to the promised land. With a hand on the whistle and a head on the brake, all Mississippi was wide awake. I see railroad officials said he's a good engineer. Casey Jones mounted to the cabin. Casey Jones orders in his hand. Casey Jones leaning out the window.
Talk about